alone.
Combating this threat will take all of us.
The call is out to help to software developers, technology experts, and leaders in the 3D printing industry. Ed Donahue, Washington.
Starliner capsule ending the Boeing's first astronaut mission last night. It landed safely in the New Mexico desert. The astronauts still stranded on the space station for 8 months. More from townhall.com.
Past performance may not be indicative of future results. Therefore, no current or prospective client should assume that the future performance of any specific investment, investment strategy, including the investments and or investment strategies recommended and or purchased by advisor or product made reference to directly or indirectly will be profitable. Different types of investment involve varying degrees of risk, and there can be no assurance that any specific investment will either be suitable or profitable for a client's investment portfolio. No client or prospective client should assume that any information presented serves as the receipt of or substitute for personalized investment advice from the advisor or any other investment professional.
Welcome to the Bullington Capital Report, hosted by Bill Bullington. For the next hour, you'll receive information on current market conditions and trends that could affect your financial future. If you have a question, you can participate in today's program by calling 216-901-0945. That's 216-901-0WHK. You can also reach Bill by going to his website, bullingtoncapital.com. And now, here's Bill Bullington.
Well, welcome back, everybody. Yeah, like the typical first week of September is typical. not a whole lot of activity, actually, in markets. Pretty much, well, the S&P actually didn't do that well. Some of the other indexes, small and mid-cap, they were probably was about either flat, slightly ahead, or slightly negative. So no big news coming down, at least not yet. I know a lot of people are looking at the election and thinking, you know, it's going to have a big impact on the stock market. And reality is it may or it may not. In fact, if you look at every election year, it's a toss of a quarter to know whether or not the market's going to head up or down, no matter which party wins the election. I always thought that that was pretty interesting.
Because everybody...
And realistically, they are so close. It really doesn't seem to matter a whole lot. And influenced heavily by what's happened in the past 20 years or the past few years, if you've had one particular party where they've a little misleading. Looking at that kind of stuff, you want to look at a long time period, look at other economic indicators, and then you'll come to the same decision I am. It wasn't worth the time you spent looking at all that stuff to try to give yourself an idea of what's going to happen. I can tell you this, same thing Warren Buffett's been saying almost his entire investing lifetime. You know, if you're going to be in stocks, you should be in them for a very long time period. You should be focusing on the next 10 years, not the next 10 weeks. And that's that hasn't really changed too much. And even though when your age gets to a certain point, if you're not really successful, and I'm talking millions of dollars, and if you have to do budgeting the way that most people do, that it's a different story. You need to be a little bit more balanced. I would look for sources of income for at least half of your assets if you're a typical, say, 60-year-old. And half your assets I would look to keep in some... got so many options now. It's just mind-boggling how many options there are. And I've been working with a company that brought out a product a few years ago that, in my mind, has passed the threshold where the threat of them having to shut down their funds because they didn't gather enough assets, I think that threat, I'm pretty sure that threat is over. Why is that important? Because if you invest in a fund, these are mostly ETFs these days, but if you invest in a fund and it doesn't gather enough in assets, if the general investing public doesn't think it's a good enough fund, or maybe they just didn't have the budget to market that fund, and they find out that, you know, that there's just not enough interest, or they just don't have enough money to put into marketing, so they're going to have to shut the fund down. Your money gets locked up for several weeks. Sometimes I've had this happen four or five times during my career. So it's made me really cautious when I'm looking at new funds that are coming out to try to figure out which ones have enough money to be able to stay in business. And so typically that's one of the reasons I just don't look at anything that's not at least 4 or 5 years old. And today would have to have at least $500 million in assets. And typically, it's probably closer to $1 billion today because they discounted fees on just about everything. So anyway, you need more money at lower fees to be able to pay your ongoing expenses. And it's a lot. I mean, they're literally several thousand exchange-traded funds. And there are tens of thousands of mutual funds that belong in various other investment vehicles like variable annuities. Those are basically tax-deferred mutual funds, 401ks. A lot of 401ks have funds made specifically for them. So, in other words, there's a lot of stuff that's out there, and trying to figure out what's going to be the best for you is unique, as everybody. I've never met two people that are identical when it comes to investing. More often than not, they'll have different ideas about what investing is, what good investing is. They'll have different ideas on risk tolerance, how much risk they have. The vast majority of people that I've talked to over the years have never looked at a really long-term chart of the S&P 500, which is an extremely difficult fund to outperform in the long run. So it being in the top 10% of its category, probably the most popular thing that people look at when they're comparing themselves, which is a bad idea, incidentally. Half of the money in that fund is in the top 50 stocks. So the other 450 don't have nearly as much influence as the top 50. Yeah. And every time I say that, it's funny. I'll get people that they go, that can't be true. And I'll tell you what. I'll bet you $10,000 in cash. Okay. You're going to have to write a check right now, I'll show you the evidence, and I can prove it to you. Yeah, but nobody ever takes me up on that. Thank goodness. I would never try to collect that in any way. But the bottom line is, markets don't work a lot like people think they do. They have a lot of people don't even care anymore, which I think is kind of funny. But so here I'm looking at the S&P 500, and the first time. This is actually the SPY. This is the fund that represents the S&P 500. And it got to $155 a share back in 2000. And it went down a little over 50%. Actually, hang on one second. I can tell you exactly what it was. It was down a little over 50%. And that took 3 years. Talk about brutal. I remember that well. And I was investing that entire time period. So the market just crashed. It took it all the way up until November of 2007 to recover. Okay, so something had been at something, the S&P 500, what people refer to as the stock market. It's not the stock market, but it's a pretty good representation, especially your more popular, bigger companies. They're in there. Okay, so those companies like Procter & Gamble, today would be Google, Amazon, companies like that, they end up dropping more than 50% over a three-year period. When they finally got back and had recovered all the losses in late 2007, early 2008, and I know a lot of people were going, great, it's finally, you know, it's recovered. And then you have another drop that goes down farther than it did the first time, and it doesn't fully correct it, at least the prices didn't fully correct until 2014. Think about that for a second. By the way, the index pays a dividend, and if you would have reinvested the dividends instead of having a 14-year negative time period, it would have only been 10. That makes you feel a lot better, right? A 10-year negative time period in the what most people refer to as the stock market. It's not. It's the S&P 500. It's a big chunk of the stock, and most stocks will move in tandem with that. You have no business being 100% in stock for the average person. If you're above average, you can live on 2 or 3% of whatever you have in your investment accounts. Great. That's not. That's very rare. Congratulations. You quote unquote. On the dividend that you get from the fund, and there are some other dividend-paying funds that have a track record that are as good or as better or better than the S&P 500. So that's a something that you could do if you really got a lot of assets out there. And that I have been talking about annuities, and I just had a little message. I need to take a real quick commercial break, so I'll be back right after these commercial messages.
Where is God in the heartache? Where is God in the fear? Where is God when it hurts so bad that you can't hold back the tears? Where is God in the sickness that the prayers didn't fix?
Bob Brandt here, and if you are dealing with a leaky roof, we should probably take care of that sooner rather than later, don't you think? Quick call to Sky Roofing will get it done, 440-349-6750. Look, there are a lot of roofing companies out there that want your business, but this isn't something you want to trust to a fly-by-night company. Sky Roofing is in it to stay. They've been serving Ohio homeowners like you and me for 24 years. That means they're doing it right by the roofs they repair, the roofs they replace, and the people that they serve. The pros at Sky Roofing have pledged to treat your roof like it was one of their own homes. So if your roof is in disrepair, maybe you've got some gaps in the shingles, call Sky Roofing. And if your roof has been good to you, but it's just that time that all homeowners face and you have to replace it, call Sky Roofing. Check out their work and the testimonials at the user-friendly website skyroofinginc.com, then make that call, 440-349-6750. Call today, get a great quote, and treat your roof the way you need your roof to treat you. Sky Roofing is roofing done right.
This is Dennis Prager, and now a truly exciting new benefit, my monthly online video get-together for Pragertopia Plus members only. For an hour each month, get an exclusive chance to ask me anything. I'll be answering your questions. I've never done this. Submit your questions for me at Pragertopia.com. This is our chance to connect like never before. Go to Pragertopia.com or click the banner at DennisPrager.com.
No doubt about it, we're spending more time at home, which is the perfect time to make it more functional and beautiful. Hi, Ed Flash Ferentz here for Artistic Renovations, Northeast Ohio's premier and award-winning remodeler. Artistic did a fantastic job with our kitchen in 2016, and last year, they were back for the master bath. Oh, my word. Do yourself a favor and go to ArtisticReno.com. Believe me, you'll love their ideas and without question, the finished product. For a virtual consultation, call 216-520-0838 or visit ArtisticReno.com.
Thinking about updating your home? Well, Joyce Factory Direct specializes in replacing old, outdated windows. Proudly made right here in Cleveland, Joyce Windows features their exclusive Smart Shield high-performance glass, which means you'll be getting the most energy-efficient windows for your home directly from the factory. Customers just love how much warmer their house is and how easy their new windows operate and clean. Right now, you can save 50% on all installations. Just call to schedule a free consultation with on-the-spot pricing, 440-243-5700, or visit JoyceFactoryDirect.com.
Well, welcome back. I was told that I had some technical difficulties here. Apologize about that. I'll go back over all the things that we were talking about. If you have any questions, you can go to my website. It's bullingtoncapital.com. Or you can email me, bill@bullingtoncapital.com. And I will get back to you as quickly as I possibly can. And I do feel like I need to mention something. Ever since the pandemic, there's been issues with internet service all over the country. And I've been talking to people outside of my industry and other industries, and everybody's kind of noticed it. You know, it's just the systems are malfunctioning a little more frequently than they have in the past. Or connections are not going through, emails are not being received. It's not constant, but it seems to like come in waves. So the reason I'm telling you this is that if you have reached out to us and we haven't reached back, then you probably need to give us a call. I wish it were different than that, but I can't control the internet, so. I can try, but that's not going to do much good. Anyway, so we're talking about fixed income, things that you can do. I just looked at how much money that somebody could generate from $100,000. That's not the minimum on these things, but there is a website that you can go to. My favorite product is a company, and it's nationwide. That's the favorite product that I have for the fixed annuities. And we use others as well. It depends on your circumstances. So before I could know exactly what that is, I would need to speak with you about it. So here I'm doing a 62-year-old that wants to retire at 67, at full retirement age, at $100,000 to invest. What could that get them? So if they're 62, they're going to retire, they want to supplement their income a little bit, they put $100,000 in. At the age of 67, the guaranteed income for a lifetime at that point is $9,990. Okay. So just a hair away from 10% of what you started with, not 10% of what it will be a few years from now. But that's pretty good to know that you could do that. It starts off actually at $7,000, and then it creeps up each year by 10%. And so at age 67, it's $9,990. And not bad. It's very, very, very difficult to generate that type of income from other types of products like fixed income products like CDs or treasury. In fact, I'm there's nothing that I know of right now that will match that. That's one of the reasons I keep bringing this up. If you're getting close to retirement age right now, every day, I forget, I think it's 10,000 people that are reaching the age of 60. So you're getting close. And to build up benefits like that, it takes a few years. So if you started at 62 and wanted to take income in 12 months, then the number would be 7,000. So putting that off by a few years brings it up to almost $10,000. That's a big difference. It's a really big difference. So if you'd like to talk about that, if you have any questions, I'm just going to kind of leave that alone. They're the higher sources of guaranteed income that you can get. And feel free to hit me up on that and ask about it. I'm the same way I am on the phone in person as I am on the radio show. Fortunately or unfortunately, I'm not sure. But anyway, in other words, we're not a high-pressure sales firm. We're a no-pressure. I really want you to do the right thing for yourself, and I'll try to help you the best I can. You can explain to me what you're looking for, and I'll let you know if it exists, which is an interesting topic. There's a large percentage of the population who comes up with an idea, or they'll take ideas that they've seen from other products out there and then put them together in their own idea of what a product should be able to do. And sometimes they're a little bit overly optimistic. And I think that's actually the hardest part of my job. I know this exists somewhere. It may only exist in your head. And I hate having to tell somebody that. It blows my mind. And one of the reasons that I've continued to talk about these fixed annuities is because the rates that they're guaranteeing right now are higher than most people. Well, I shouldn't say most. They're higher than a lot of people are going to get in their stock portfolios. So that's the first reason. The second reason is they don't fluctuate. That schedule is guaranteed. Okay. It's not like the stock market, which is all over the place. Look at the ETF SPY. That represents the S&P 500, what a lot of people refer to as the stock market. It's not the whole stock market, but most people are familiar with the S&P 500 if they're investing at all. Well, that peaked in 2022, okay? And actually, it was 2021 near the end of the year. No, actually, the first week in 2022. It's 2024 now, okay? Actually, we're going on to we're almost through 2024, and it's only up 12.2%. And it's been down a lot, almost a third. And took it a long time to get back to break even. And now it's just slightly ahead of where it was. You cannot afford to do that when you're retired. In your retirement years, if you look at the long-term returns, they look great. What people forget or don't know, people that aren't willing to pay, for some software that will actually show them. There may be some free software out there somewhere, but software I have is kind of expensive. It shows you what things have done in the past, and projecting that out into the future as if it's never going to change, not a good idea in either direction. And so I guess that's one of the things that we try to have conversations with an awful lot of investors. You get closer to retirement. Yeah, the stock market's really hard to beat if you look in a super long run. But you look out over the past few years, and it could either be misleading as if it's going to keep going up. And let's say that somebody just started investing in the fourth quarter of 2022. Well, they think the market does nothing but go straight up. And when it does have a correction, it only comes down a few percentage points, and then it turns around and starts heading right back up again. So the people that got started investing in the fourth quarter of 2021 have a completely different picture. They see a market that lost a third of its value and took a little over 2 years to make that up. And that's not even a big decline. You know, you get the big declines like you had in the early 2000s. Those are huge. As soon as that one, it was more than 50%. When it went down, when it recovered, it turned around and went down 50% again. So, stocks do have a better super long-term track record than almost everything else, but they fluctuate like crazy. And yes, you're going to need them. No, I wouldn't recommend that you use the S&P 500 for 100% of that. It's too volatile. It takes too long to recover. There are other stock funds out there. We're going to be talking more about those in the future, collections of stocks that you can actually put together in an effort to improve on the performance and recovery periods of just putting your money into the S&P 500. That's coming. Okay, it's going to take me a couple months to run the rest of to complete the research I need. And I know it's there. It's always been there. And one of the reasons I started using exchange-traded funds was because they started to go down that path, making those other offerings available. Well, at one point in time, it was great. You know, before almost everybody on the planet was doing it. Now that everybody's doing it, their returns on what the mainstream industry is involved in are nearly identical. I mean, and it's okay. It is okay. It's if people have the discipline, there's enough availability to of good performing products that I think are going to help you reach your goals. I think you could do it. However, it's bumpier than it has been in the past. And my feeling is that, well, if you're going to put up with that kind of volatility, you should be being paid for that. You should be making a little bit more than you're making. And so we're working on that project, and I will keep you posted on it. In the meantime, I mean, it's incredibly difficult to outperform, whether it's bonds or stocks, the guaranteed values of a lot of the indexed annuities. And I've had a lot of people calling in and say, hey, why are you talking about these annuities so much? You used to talk more about stocks. Well, it was easier to beat those numbers with stocks in the past than it is today. Valuations are pretty decent today. They're still overpriced. Stocks are still overpriced, but they're not as overpriced as they were 2.5 years ago, 3 years ago, when the price level was about where it is now, except that we haven't had the growth that the economy has experienced. And that's another topic. The growth rate in the economy is actually pretty good. And a lot of people are wondering, like, where is this coming from? You hear that a lot in the Wall Street Journal or Barron's. They're looking at this, and the first thing they go, well, this just must be a fluke, and it's probably going to go away. And then you dig deeper, and you find out where the increases in the economy are coming from. And it's the same thing it's kind of been for the past, I don't know, probably 30 or 40 years minimally. And it's increases in technological knowledge that turns into new products, it turns into new industries, and that's what's driving the economy. That's what's always driven the economy, and it's what's going to drive it 100 years into the future. And the rate of change is actually increasing a little bit, as it has been over the past 4 or 5 years, and that's one of the reasons that stock prices have done as well as they have, because a lot of the companies that are producing these products that are the newfangled ones, the one that we consume a ton of, they're publicly traded. And that's a good thing. That's what helps build wealth, helps maintain wealth done correctly over time. So I feel really good about that. I look around, I go, wow, yeah, I can see these things being brought to fruition. I remember, oh, man, it's hard to believe how long I've been doing this. it was at least, I'm going to say somewhere between 15 and 20 years ago. And I was talking about electric cars. And actually, Tesla wasn't the leader. It was, I think it was Nissan. And Nissan had this car called the Leap. And it was the one of the first electric cars to be manufactured in volume. And unfortunately, they couldn't sell enough of them to dominate that marketplace. And of course, Elon Musk came along, and Tesla's now everybody knows who Tesla is. I remember telling people, well, there's this guy. His name is Elon Musk. And when he was a kid, he invented this banking app that was like super popular. It got bought out by I can't even remember what the name of it is. It's really a popular banking service that's an online. They were one of the first ones. Now, dude did that when he was really young. It was mind-boggling. Sorry, it's one of the many geniuses out there in the world bringing these products to us. And that's the one thing I really kind of enjoy about keeping up with the stock market is you hear about these innovations. Oftentimes, you're reading about it several years before it's mainstream. And that can be a little frustrating because you're thinking, if they've got these products, why are they not bringing them out? Well, it's not that easy. You've got to be able to handle you have to build capacity. First of all, that's the ability to create enough product to satisfy demand for your products. You've got to figure out all the logistics. And I never really paid too close attention to that when I was a kid. But that is a major, that's a major link to being able to grow and sustain businesses. You have to have distribution. And, years and years ago, and I can't imagine that would change a whole lot. Those were the, some of the leading majors at, at Annapolis, particularly Annapolis. It's, I was thinking to myself when I was talking to, I actually tried to get in the Marine Corps as an officer, and 3 days before I got my orders. I even got an aviator slot. I was going to be a pilot. And 3 days before I had to go to Quantico, to officer candidate school, I had my appendix removed in an emergency surgery. So I still had to show up, by the way, and didn't pass physical because I still had the stitches in my abdomen. I was going to try and do it anyway. And they said, no, you can't do that. So that was the end of that. But anyway, I was introduced to logistics. When you think about it, military, they buy everything. They buy pens, paper, clothing, food, cars, trucks, planes, helicopters, you name it. They buy almost everything. And and actually, when you add the government purchasing together, it's about a third, almost a third of GDP in the United States. So I'm not even sure why I thought all this was important, other than the fact that, when people are losing confidence in the economy, in the country, unfortunately for them, for most people, they didn't get that experience to see all that stuff working. And then when I got out of school, I had a job selling ads in a magazine that went out to government purchasers at all levels of government. Talk about an eye opener. Holy cow! Government is a huge portion of the economy, and most people think of federal government, but they don't realize you've got call them military. They're under the government's rule. You've got cities, states, counties. Yeah, all of them have governments, and they all have purchasing police and fire. That's part of your government. And they're buying trucks and cars all the time. A lot of them have their own garages. So there's, in other words, when you hear these gloom and doom stories, you have to remember how many people it takes to keep the economy going and how long we've been doing this. It is a really, really long time period. What does that mean? Well, what that means is it's probably going to be pretty good. That things keep going along the path that they're going now, it's good. You know, is it going to slow down? Yeah, it slows down every once in a while. We call it a recession. And then it bottoms out and picks back up. The government knows how to adjust monetary policies. They'll adjust taxes. That's fiscal policy. And they can get us back on the right track eventually. And so it works out very, very well. In the short run, you got to kind of figure out how you're going to get along, because the government doesn't have, it's not a person, doesn't have an age or life expectancy. We do. So when we come back from these commercial messages, we'll talk a little bit about how do you invest to make sure that you don't run out of money during your life expectancy. So this is Bill Bullington. I'm right here on 1420. I'll be back right after these messages.
We had water seeping up the drain in the basement, and that's always alarming.
She says, why don't we call Wyatt Works? And I was like, oh, yeah, that's those whistling plumbers.
Everything was top-notch professional, but friendly and personal. And I liked it. I think women tend to like that in a different way than men, but we both appreciated all of that.
Being an old guy, I'm impressed with young men who can present themselves like that.
I got to tell you, the one line from your ads that sticks with me is, I'd rather starve than do business that way. And then when your men came to our house and did that work, I could tell that was not just a line on an ad. That was what they really mean.
You guys lived up to your advertising.
They are men of a higher caliber, definitely, definitely.
Consider it done at WyattWorks.com.
Wallacadoodle.
Do you ever find yourself saying, I need a vacation? Vacation Fixation can help. At Vacation Fixation, we specialize in all-inclusive trips and cruises to Mexico, the Caribbean, and Disney vacations. Why choose us? Our clients book through Vacation Fixation because they are frustrated with online trip brokers and timeshare scams. Whether it's a weekend getaway, a family trip, spring break, or honeymoon, Vacation Fixation will personalize a trip just for you. Want to know the hottest destinations in Cancun, Punta Cana, Jamaica, or Puerto Vallarta? Interested in room upgrades, beach reviews, or details about resort restaurants? How about finding a trip with a direct flight? At Vacation Fixation, we take all of your specific travel requests and shop our suppliers to find the best deal. What's the cost? Our suppliers pay us so you don't have to. Call 330-573-8147 for more details. Or you can visit our website at vacationfixation.com or check out the deal of the day on Facebook. Vacation Fixation.
Is it finally time to update your bathroom? Bath Planet, a division of Joyce Factory Direct, specializes in replacing and converting old showers and tubs into new beautiful bathrooms in as little as one day. We have transformed thousands of bathrooms just like yours into a spa-like oasis that has homeowners excited to use their new bathtub or shower. Right now, all bath installations are 50% off. So call to schedule a free consultation with on-the-spot pricing. 440-243-5700 or visit JoyceFactoryDirect.com.
Welcome back. This is the Bullington Capital Report. I'm Bill Bullington, here every Saturday morning from 11 to noon. If you hear anything you'd like more information on, feel free to give me a call at 330-664-0700. Or you can go to my website. It's bullingtoncapital.com. There's a contact us page. And I would try to call first. I'll tell you, ever since the pandemic, a lot of the services that we provide, and a lot of our big providers are biggest in the country, and they're a little bit wonky. It really depends. And I have to say they've all been that way, kind of, in one way, shape, or form, some way, shape, or form, rather. And I think Fidelity's probably been the least. We are a customer of theirs, so we manage money for our clients, and sometimes we use them. In fact, we use them more frequently than we use others, particularly since the pandemic. We've got the biggest budget when it comes to IT, and we've had the least number of issues. If you're a client and you'd like to switch to them from one of the other providers, you know, give us a call. We're trying to reach out, or I'm trying to reach out, and so is my staff. But sometimes it's hard to get people to respond. Yeah, which I always thought was kind of crazy. I mean, it's only your money, but it's not like it's life or death. You know, it's just a little more convenient. And anyway, something else very convenient. Intel is building that plant down in southern Ohio. It's not too far. I have a place. I have two places. I split my time between. It is mind-boggling. If you want to learn more about it, you could just Google the Intel Ohio plant. It'll take you to their website, and it can tell you much better than I can about what they're doing. And there are the number of jobs that it's going to be created is just mind-boggling, and they're going to be investing, it says, more than $28 billion. And there, I didn't realize it was two chip factories. You know, I thought it was just one. But the campus is going to be on nearly 1,000 acres. And that's right in New Albany, just outside of Columbus. This is pretty cool. I mean, for Ohio to get something like this, I think is, you know, very happy for the state itself. Very proud that they selected this area, and very exciting. I mean, I can hardly wait to see what comes into the future. And I remember thinking a long time ago, when cell phones first, you know, dropped in price, we used to call them car phones because you had to have them mounted in your car. My first cell phone was a car phone that was literally mounted to the floorboard in my car. And I was just talking. That's hilarious. I didn't realize that the connection had dropped. But I'm going to have to tell Intel about that. I was just talking about Intel on that plant that's coming up. If you want to, you can Google it, and it'll probably bring you right to place, but intel.com/content/corporate responsibility. Actually, I would probably just go to Google and type in the Intel in Ohio together. Take a little time with that. I mean, when people ask me, I get accused oftentimes of being overly optimistic. And I'm like, no, I just read a lot. Yeah, and I read a lot. I watch a lot of now up on YouTube. You can get a lot of research, high quality research, just on YouTube, and it's free. That's mind boggling. I remember when they first started talking about YouTube, I was so excited. I thought, holy cow! You know, some kids, his own shows, put them up online, and people are going to like them, and they'll be famous all over the world. And this is when they. All right, wow. I can't wait until this new technology catches up with us. I apologize for it dropping like that. That is, yeah, that's such a bummer. So I've only got a few minutes left here, and a couple of the things I just wanted to make sure that you heard today. Technology is moving faster than it ever has, and that's going to be a big boost for the stock market. However, stock market fluctuates a lot. As you get older, if you want to maintain your return or maintain a good return, or if you want returns that are going to be higher than what you could get from traditional fixed income methods, then you may want to take a look at an annuity. For years, I didn't like annuities because I didn't think, you know, I'm looking at the really long term and thinking, well, you know, the S&P's averaged 9-10% a year, depending on which 20-year period that you were looking at. And I think that's going to be incredibly difficult to beat. But realistically, when you start getting closer to the retirement age, you don't have that time to wait for a big correction to recover. So that's why I started incorporating annuities into my practice. Because a lot of my clients, they're like I am. They're even closer to retirement. Can't afford to take a 50% hit that takes 10 years to recover from. It's just not cool. Especially if I'm, you know, here I am 3-4 years away from retirement. I put $100,000 into an investment that's going to guarantee $10,000 a year in income for as long as I live when I decide to start turning it on. And that's pretty good. That's incredibly difficult to beat. So at any rate, that's all on a website. If you want the link to that website, just email me. It's bill@bullingtoncapital.com. You can put your own age in there and the own dollar amount that you're thinking about, and it'll give you a projection on what those guaranteed numbers are. And you can reach out to me by either emailing me, bill@bullingtoncapital.com, or you can call us in the office. And it's 330-664-0700. My office number, again, is 330-664-0700. And I'll get that information out to you as quickly as I can. Normally, it's just an email. And it's a really good time, I think, for all this kind of stuff. And again, I'm really excited about the plant coming to Ohio. I can't believe that they picked us out of all the 50 states out there. So guess don't look a gift horse in the mouth would be appropriate to sum that up. Anyway, this is Bill Bullington. I'm here every Saturday morning from 11 to noon on 1420. Been here for since 1996. Can you believe that? I can't. But at any rate, feel free to reach out and give us a call if you want any more information on anything you've heard up here. I'll be glad to send it to you. And other than that, have a good week, everybody. Good luck and good investing.
Just caught another edition of the Bullington Capital Report, broadcasting every Saturday at 11 a.m. on AM 1420, The Answer. If you have a question and you'd like to speak to Bill personally, you can call him at 330-664-0700. That's 330-664-0700. Or online at bullingtoncapital.com. That's bullingtoncapital.com.
The preceding program has been paid for by Bullington Capital Management, LLC.